So we have to humble ourselves.
Yes.
And recognize that we are in the presence of God all the time.
Yes.
He redeemed you. He set you free. So start messing. So stop messing up. Stop messing around and realize there's nothing in us that can save us. It's only by the grace and mercy of God and the love that He has for us. Why are you so mindful of man? Because you made us. Yes. And you made us in love because you wanted us to be with you. And because of Adam's mistake, you came and died for us so that you could bridge the gap and bring us back together. So that you can intercede on our behalf. I thank you, God the Son. I thank you that you imparted the Holy Spirit to help us, to give us wisdom and to give us the knowledge and to give us an understanding. It is not you that is getting you through the storm. It is not you that's paying those bills. It's not you that's saving your child. It's God. So, my brothers and sisters, in times like these, you need a Savior. In times like these, you need an anchor. In times like these, you need God. So, honey, I said, this is a faith walk. If ever a faith walk, this is it. But God gave me a little piece this morning in my devotional book. As I was reading it, it says, God had to prepare the disciples by telling them to sit and wait. They got word. They knew now that Jesus was a risen Savior. They were so excited. Can't wait to get out to tell everybody. But God said, wait. Why wait? Let us do it now. No, wait. Because you're not ready yet. I need to give you a little more of your spirit. Sometimes in our faith walk, God just wants us to. Because God knows we're not ready. But when the blessing comes, we instantly know it was I, it was God. It wasn't I, it was God. So in times like these, as the world is turning topsy-turvy, you see it all around. In times like these, you need a Savior. Amen. Hymn 5:19.
And raise the song.
And if you are very sure that your anchor holds and grips the solid rock, then stay with me. God is your refuge, and He's your anchor. Though the storm will rage, God is your anchor.
Amen.
He's your solid rock. Heavenly Father, you see each one of us. And in the depths of our hearts, we are committing ourselves to you with humble hearts. We surrender ourselves to you with contrite hearts. We surrender ourselves to you, and with repentant hearts we move away from that which causes us to take our focus off of you. We ask, dear Lord, that you bring us to that place where we can say, it is well with our soul. Hide us in the cleft of the rock. Place your hand over our face as you pass by, so that we may see the goodness of God, that we may recognize and realize all my goodness is filthy rags. So anoint us afresh anew. Help us to love one another. Help us to be compassionate and sensitive to each other. Bring us fully into the fold. Give us vision that we can see beyond the smirky smiles and just accept the person for who they are. Bless them. Father, if there is one that really needs to surrender their heart to you, I ask them to step out and step forward, that we may pray with them. But should they need a little more privacy, my elders and I are always available. So bless now, we pray in Jesus' name. We're going to invite Sister Kenya. We're going to invite Sister Kenya and Brother Dwayne Jenkins Jr. We didn't give them the right hand of fellowship last.